Hello and welcome. My name is Oren, and today we're going to speak and discuss the structure of the FlexNet Publisher license file structure. So, when will you get a license file? When the vendor is using the normal FLEXlm way and not the new trusted storage method that we have discussed in previous videos. So the license file provides the entitlement. What can you use? And let's see the structure in general and then dive into the details. So I see the server line. This is my server, and that's the identification of the server. So an ID that we relate this server to, and this is a port number. And then we see the vendor OpenLM in this example. And then the features are coming. This is my entitlements, and it goes one by one in multiple lines. So let's start with the server line. This is the format in general. So we see the server and then the host. Host is a name. You can typically edit it manually after that. We see the host ID, the port where we are serving it, and this is the whole format. We'll see that in the next slide. And let's see two examples. One is just a simple single server configuration where we see the server, name of the license manager, the server ID, and then the port. If you have multiple servers, so you have redundancy, we see three lines in the same license file, and then we can use it on all three servers. So this is LM1, LM2, LM3, the codes and the ports, which can be different. So let's go into the details now. So a host, you can write the host or the IP address of the server. You can edit it. So the vendor provides you the license file. You can change it. You can set the host. But then there is the host ID. Host ID is something you can't edit. And typically the vendor will ask you to run this command, lm host ID. It will return a string, and that's what you're going to give him, and you will get it with your license file. It's encoded into the file. So if you change it, the whole file doesn't work anymore. Port number, that's simple. You can set it anytime. You can change it. You stop the server, you change the port, you start it again. You get the port number. For triad, you can set specific server to be the master, and then you just write near this server, primary is master, and that set this one to become the primary. Heartbeat interval is used for triad. So it set the timeout. There is a formula, we don't need to go into the details, all the details just now, but the idea is that if you have a slower network or you distributed the triad servers on different locations, maybe in your country, maybe globally, you might have slower communication time, and the free license server that plays the triad needs to communicate all the time. And that's why we need to set higher timeout in order not to see failures of the triad, the whole triad. So next line is the vendor line. And simple example can be vendor OpenLM. So that's a very simple one, but the format allows us to add more things. So we see vendor, then the name of the vendor, and then we see vendor daemon pass. So where is the executable created by the vendor that is playing all the licensing actions? So you might see that. I didn't see that in many cases because people install the default installation, the default structure, and it's done automatically, but you can specify that. The second one, option file path, the same. If you name it vendor and OPT, so openlm.opt, it automatically finds it. You don't need to deal with it. But you can specify if you have a special structure in your installation. And then the port. The port is important because in most cases, you won't see it. When you connect, the license manager will assign you a temporary port number, and that's what's going to be used. So why should we specify the port? In case the customers are outside our network and we need to open ports through the firewall in order to allow them to consume. Because as a customer of FlexLM, you need to communicate with two different ports, the FlexLM port and the vendor port. And if you're on the local network, it doesn't matter. It works anyway. But if you are in a more complex network or outside the company network, you need to open the vendor port. And in order to open the port, you need to set it directly here, and you just set the port number. So an example would be vendor OpenLM and port 75,000. Next, we go on the actual entitlement. So entitlement can come as features or increment. So what's the difference? So from the FlexLM manual, we found you can find this. A feature line does not give an additional number of licenses, whereas an increment line always gives an additional number of licenses. In reality, in many cases, we see only increments. So here is an example of if license file, it's a real one, just changed all the detail, but it's only increments. And we see that with many vendors. The reason why I'm not going into the details now is that feature and increments are very complex and will dedicate a whole video for it. So we will discuss that in details in the next video. So I would like to thank you very much for joining and listening today. Today we discussed the structure of the FlexLM license file as provided by the vendor. Thank you for joining today.